has over 17 years experience within the IT industry. Whoa. His forte lies in new generation sales and marketing involving internet automation and IP services, particularly VoIP.
Wow.
He is the Chief Executive Officer at Otel Telecom. Please welcome Mohammed Patel.
Yeah.
Good afternoon. Yes, it's already afternoon. First of all, thank you very much to Miro and its management to give me the opportunity to share my experiences and my views to you. It's very nice to see many familiar faces of clients, as well as meeting a lot of clients and finally putting a face to a name. I'm Mohammed Patel. I'm the CEO of Otel Telecom. We provide infrastructure as a service to wireless internet service providers, ISPs, IT, and PBX companies nationwide. I'm here to speak to you about how to sell VoIP to Africa. Needless to say, in the past 2 years or so, VoIP has changed quite a bit from what it was to what it is today. People now understand VoIP. When you walk into a client, 2 years ago, they were like, ooing and aahing, we know what, it doesn't work, they heard it doesn't work, and they don't want to know about it. But if you go to people today, it's very easy to actually sell VoIP over to them. Because a lot of the major providers in South Africa are actually using VoIP as well. I'm not going to touch much onto the benefits of VoIP because Greg has covered it quite well. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to mention to you a few ways on how to sell VoIP and how to change the negatives into positives. Because VoIP is becoming very, very popular internationally and everything is becoming convergence-based, I think Bertus was mentioning about that earlier in the conference, to upgrade to Telephone 2.0 is inevitable. In the past, how I would consider the copper cabling of telecom and how they used to use telephony was more like having two tin cans and a piece of string between it. That's the old telephone. Today, VoIP has got so much potential. You can increase so much productivity within the service. However, whenever you do go to a client to sell in VoIP, although they open up their arms and they welcome the offer and the quotes and so on, there's still a lot of caution. Because unfortunately, in South Africa, the infrastructure, the cabling, the backhaul infrastructure is very, very unstable. There's very often downtime. And as you all know, downtime, even for an hour, within a corporate environment can actually wreak havoc. I mean, there's a lot of problems if the telephone lines are down, because ultimately, communications is the lifeblood of every business. I mentioned earlier, the biggest challenge is the last mile connectivity, because the VoIP providers, they have the switches in data centers, all connected up with fiber, and have power redundancy. They've done everything. But the problem is the connection between your customer and the provider. To give me a bit more information on who I'm speaking to, who is already providing VoIP services to customers? Do you mind raising your hand, please? Okay, there's quite a bit. Okay, so I understand now which way I must approach the presentation. As you all know, the most common way to actually connect to VoIP is ADSL. Why ADSL? Because it's the lowest price, the cheapest way to connect to broadband, and it's most widely available around the country. So it's very, very easy to actually connect a customer over ADSL and connect to the VoIP. It's up and running in very, very short time. However, some exchanges are over-contended. So you can't really, with confidence, go into a customer and set up a whole VoIP system, and a couple of weeks later you realize, well, you know what, it's not working for them, it's breaking up, these speech issues, these connection issues, because that exchange, a particular exchange, is over-contended. Now, this causes quite a bit of a problem. A lot of the times, the customer will say, you know, please take your equipment out, I'd rather go back to telecom, because it's affecting my business, and I'm losing business. And that's something that you can't really afford to lose. DSL speeds at monthly end is also very slow, because everybody is online, doing the banking, doing this and doing that. And month end, it's horrible. I think if you examine your support calls, you'll notice that towards the end of the month is when a lot of people actually call in, and they complain about the voice alert. And there's nothing really you can tell them. You can tell them as much as you want. You might just as well put a tape recorder there and let it loop. Sorry, your ADSL is down, or your ADSL is bad at the moment. There's really nothing you can do about it. Rain also causes bad connection in certain areas, because some exchanges are not, maybe they're very old, or there's the water, it's very bad. The rain goes in and it causes a lot of problems, really. I'm actually lost for words, because the amount of problems we have with ADSL is tremendous. Another thing is that when you walk into a customer, don't feel overconfident. Don't walk in and tell a customer, listen, I'm putting in a telephone in there for you, it's going to work. The customer has to understand that if your internet connection is down, you will have no telephones. If your power is down, and if you don't have a UPS powering up your DSL router and so on, you will have no telephones. You rather have 10 clients who tell you this up front, and they show the concern up front, and you don't sign them on, then you sign on everybody and have one loudmouth who doesn't understand what you're saying, doesn't understand of these risks, and they go out and badmouth you all over. And this causes more damage, especially in smaller towns. What you should actually do is that a lot of the other broadband facilities in South Africa is not feasible, such as DigiNet, and so they're quite expensive. So you have to go for ADSL connections. But now, let's take ADSL, and let's try and tweak it a little bit in order to make sure that you can actually work with it. The first things first is that use an MPLS network. Try and keep SIP away from the internet. Don't let the SIP packet go onto the internet, start bouncing around everywhere and coming back to and coming to the recipient, because you are going to lose quality, you are going to break the call and so on. So that's one thing you should try and do. Always try and keep it away from the internet. Avoid using ISP's ADSL accounts, such as a local only, or especially these new uncapped accounts. Those are very, very bad to use. You will definitely have issues with those accounts. Try and set up a VPN router. Try and set up tunnels or something like that. Wireless internet service providers, what they do is that they would aggregate all the wireless subconnections, put a QoS on it, and bring it over to their central point, load balance a couple of ADSL lines, and try and run it with an IPC or an MPLS network. It is recommended, if you are a fairly large OS and you're running a number of concurrent calls as a backhaul onto your ADSL, run through a lease line. Lease lines, there's DigiNet, there's fiber in certain areas, it is very cost effective, and also there's private lease lines. You can contact me after the show and I'll explain to you a bit more about the lease lines. The next problem is that the most common question is, if the ADSL line is down, will the lines be operational? And obviously you know the answer to that, the lines will not be operational, but there's a couple of solutions to it. What you could do is that, the answer is quite simple. If the ADSL line is down in the area, maybe the copper cables are stolen or whatever, it is very likely that the voice lines, even the standard voice lines, will also be down. So what you could do is that you could set the customer's phones or your server to detect whether there is connection. Is the phone pinging or the gateway pinging to the server or not? If it is not pinging to the server, then automatically create a call forward. Let it forward over to the cell phones or something like that. The next one is, if you have a wireless service provider coming, WISP, and your VoIP packets come over to your central point, and you're backhauling over ADSL, and you don't have DigiNet or whatever, try and have sort of 3G backup just for your voice. For internet, when people are down on internet, they don't really mind, they can wait an hour or so for the email to come through. But if the phone lines are down, all hell breaks loose. You can offer both those facilities either at a cost, maybe you could have redundancy as an additional cost and things like that. So it's extra money for you. Airtime profit. Now this I have to cover quite quickly. I'm running a bit out of time, but this is very, very important because yes, when the interconnect rates came down, as an end user, they were ecstatic. They were very happy. Why? Because the calls are cheap and so on. Not that it actually became cheaper, but they say the calls are a bit cheaper and so on. So lower interconnect fees is good. The end users are happy. But for service providers and all those who raise your hands who are already providing a service, you have noticed that your profitability has shrunk. Your margin has shrunk. You are making less profit on airtime. So you cannot now bank on airtime anymore. And many times they used to give you rebates. Even those rebates are gone, or they've shrunk. It's very, very difficult to actually make money on airtime anymore. The larger players have reduced their call rates, so your margin also have reduced. Another poll I need to find out is that providing the customer with a service, would you rather just provide them a proper service with good service backup support, or a properly marketed, fully featured solution with quality support at a mid-level price, or B, offering the cheapest solution on the market in your region? Who says for A? And for B? Okay, there's considerably more A's than B. There's very little B. So yes, so you're all saying that price is not really the factor at the moment. So you do agree in a way that if your phone lines are down, it's bad. It's really, really bad. So you rather provide a good quality service at a reasonable price, which your customer will not mind paying, but then you have enough profitability to be able to support him on the after-sales service. The solution is three. There are three solutions to the airtime problem. The first solution is the packaging. Now, you are most likely buying airtime at pure per second from your service provider. And when you have this pure per second, the biggest mistake everybody does is that they just go out and they sell it pure per second as well. You can't do that because you will not make profit if you go and sell it pure per second. You need to package this VoIP service very, very nicely. See how the cellular providers package it. Oh, I'll give you this phone and I'll give you this. I think 2 months ago, so they had a BlackBerry for 79 rand a month or 99 rand a month. But what they don't tell you is that they're charging you per minute billing. Now there's a lot of money in per minute billing. Moving on, I'm just going to go through this very, very quickly. If you are packaging, you must create a good balance between your customer's price that he wants to pay and also your profitability. That's very important. Whenever you are providing a customer with low call rates, ensure that you are charging him a lot more on a fixed line rental, because you need to cover the service of the customer. The point is, you give him the best service, the best deal, but no service. For WISPs, for wireless internet service providers and ISPs, bundle your airtime with the wireless service, because that is added value. Do not try to compete on price, because you will lose. You will find a smaller guy out there who will come through and cut your price in half. Don't go there. You focus onto your package, onto your business. You need to be sustainable. You have X number of technicians to pay, X number of vehicles on the road to maintain. You need to create your package very, very smartly. I would recommend deciding on your selling points. Are you selling on low price, premium service, top-notch support? Is offering local, regional, nationwide? Who are your competitors? What do you do offer that they don't? These may be ideas to start with. The second solution is the calculating of cost. Remember one thing, that when you are calculating your cost, it's not a question of you just buying X amount from your provider and adding on 10% and selling it. No, that is not your cost. Your cost, you've got to include your cost of your servers, your maintenance, licensing, client support. Everything must be factored into your cost. Another very big mistake that people do is that you go in, you sell VoIP with free calling. oh, you know what, if you dial within our network, it's free calling. Maybe it worked two, three years ago, because you really needed to tell this guy to, you know, sign up for the phone. But in today's time, it's very, very difficult, because that free calling is still using your network. You still have to maintain those networks. If that guy's network is down, if his CPE is down, he's not going to phone you and say, listen, you know what, my CPE is down, I can't call or whatever. Meantime, you're thinking, you know what, I'm giving this guy free calling, and you know, it doesn't work that way. If you're giving a service, you've got to give a full service. So the free calling, yes, give it as a free, give free calling as a bait. Don't give it as a bait. Don't give it away for free. Have some things like terms and conditions or fair use policies and all that into place. Play around with it. You'll come through. The next one is charging plans. There's a third solution for you. The charging plans, you should look at who your customer is. For residential customers, for example, their call charges is not going to be too much. It's going to be very low. So you've got to somehow charge them a fixed service fee, where you know that even if this guy doesn't call for the whole month, at least you know you're getting your monthly service fee on a monthly basis. When you do the billing, the charging plan for him, don't charge him pure per second or whatever. Charge him per minute billing, because at the end of the day, you're still a bit cheaper than telco. And most likely, if you are a wireless internet service provider providing him a VoIP service, he does not have telco in his location. So why not just give him the service at a profitable rate for you and at a good rate for him that he's happy with the service and he's paying per minute billing at a low rate too. If you're selling to medium and small to medium enterprises, what I would suggest you do is that you give per second, no problem, but you've got to cover your infrastructure costs. So have a minimum charge for the client. You could start with maybe say first 30 seconds. So even if he calls for 25 seconds or 10 seconds, you're going to charge him the first 30 seconds, and thereafter is per second, which is what you actually, which is profitable for you because you can sustain your business with that. And the large enterprises, they have large volumes of minutes. There you can go pure per second because your competitors are coming at pure per second and you got to match it. However, make your money offline rental. Sell him a hosted PBX solution, sign up a maintenance contract, and so on and so on. I'm going to go a bit faster. Conversion from analog to digital. This is very, very important because the number one unspoken objection is when you go into a customer, in order for him to move from analog to digital, he's going to think, oh my God, now this guy's going to be here for 2-3 days and he's going to disrupting my business and be a problem and so on and so on. So what you should actually do is you walk in with a plan. Be confident, you walk in with a plan and listen, sir, on first day this is what I'm going to do, on the second day that's what I'm going to do, and on the third day we'll do the switchover at night so that you don't have any problems, and we'll even take away the old stuff if you don't want to. You know, come in with confidence, and the customer will be happy with that. Anyway, if you have any other questions or anything like that, I'll be available at where we're having lunch just now. And thank you very much.
Another round of applause, Mr.